Thanks so much for joining us here on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Charlene Israel. Tensions are running high in Egypt today. The Muslim Brotherhood, angry over the ouster of President Mohamed Morsi, calling for mass protests. Meanwhile, the army is holding Morsi and other Muslim Brotherhood officials under house arrest. CBN Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell has more.
Millions of Egyptians celebrated the army's takeover in the streets of Cairo on Thursday. They see the army as the protector of the revolution that started 2 years ago.
I am here now because I am so happy for Egypt. My feeling is that I have my country back. We never liked anything done by the Muslim Brotherhood. This is the first time in 50 years that my heart is warmed.
The jubilation comes just 1 year after the Muslim Brotherhood's Morsi was elected president of the country, bringing Islamists to power for the first time. Many felt he betrayed the people and destroyed the economy.
We are standing here victorious. We want to complete our victory by bringing in the people who are going to rule the country. Because, as you know, the ruler of the country was unjust. They even lacked religion, and they wanted to divide us as religious and secular, and they managed to do it.
Some called for calm.
All that I ask of our great people who are supporting the ousted president is to close the gap that is between the Egyptian people. We should all unite and forget about the past.
But Islamists are not backing down, and it looks like trouble could be on the way.
We will be protesting until the return of President Morsi to rule and to be the president again, or we die here as martyrs. This sit-in must not stay just that. We are supposed to bring more crowds, and we should move to more sensitive places, like the Ministry of Defense and to the Supreme Constitutional Court. And if we knew where Morsi is being held, we would go there and release him.
The White House stopped short of calling the overthrow a military coup. A coup would usually trigger economic sanctions and a cut in U.S. aid. In neighboring Israel, officials are not commenting on developments, but are concerned that Islamists could take advantage of any chaos in the country to launch attacks from the Sinai Desert or Gaza Strip into Israel. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.